Holy Water. The third drop B song, and but I don't know if it was the third one that I wrote. It might have been the first one. I just remember the again, kind of like Rusty Cage, the fact that I could make these great, cool sounding triad chords with the drop B, yep. where it was easy positions and it sounded unlike anything I'd heard, and it was sort of easy to write to for that moment. You know, I think as time went on, it was more difficult because it's only three notes, and it would all sort of sound like something I'd already done, but it felt unique at the time, and it was kind of inspiring. And that there's a big riff, but it's also there's a lot of chord changes and all around three note chords.
Yeah, I was like the timbre of your voice on that one.
Yeah, it was sort of warmer and deeper. There, it had that one part. It had that part that stylistically, finger wise, kind of was reminiscent of the Beatles part in Searching with My Good Eye Closed.
Yes,
that part is like bitty little 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 little, and well, you know that it comes in somewhere there, but there's something I love about that song is the tag at the end is such a, to me, guitar wise, it's such a strong riff that it seems like it could have built a song around that on its own, but it's just there's something sort of measured and restrained about just letting it be this tag at the end and not necessarily expanding. It just gives this weight to that song.
Mm-hmm.
By the way,
it's a perfect segue into New Damage too, when you think about it, going from like what you're just describing as the, it could have been its own song or building to a new song, and then all of a sudden there's the sun down.
It's got a very bluesy sort of a slinky bar like feel to it, and then at the end is this entirely different thing. It's heavy and it's, you know, it's a irregular rhythm.
Book. Boom.
Yeah. Know?